Do you remember Flight 10 and what made it so unforgettable? For me, the striking orange and light glow around the spacecraft's heat shield upon re-entry was the highlight. This visual spectacle captivated audiences worldwide, myself included. Flight 11, on the other hand, was impressive for a completely different reason. Rather than being a step backward, it represented a significant advancement. This mission demonstrated how SpaceX had improved one of Starship's critical systems, the heat shield, resulting in improved stability and efficiency. The improvements functioned flawlessly, confirming that SpaceX's innovation was paying off. So, how did SpaceX improve the heat shield this time around, and why is its significance crucial to Starship's future? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. Truly, we have witnessed yet another stunning and motivating Starship flight. Remarkably, it has achieved another flawless success. In many ways, this operation surpasses the achievements of Flight 10. I'll explain why. What makes Flight 11 a true milestone for SpaceX engineering? While Flight 10 was considered a success, it wasn't without its flaws. The most obvious issue was the appearance of the S-37 heat shield upon re-entry, which displayed a striking orange and white hue. Musk later indicated that a coolant leak caused oxidation on the metallic heat shield tiles, creating the striking metallic color. While this visual appeal captivated the public, it raised substantial technical concerns. For a spacecraft designed for repeated use and extended missions, any oxidation or damage to the heat shield could jeopardize its reusability and long-term reliability. To address this, SpaceX implemented a series of significant upgrades for Flight 11. One significant modification was the introduction of what they called crunch wrap, a new arrangement intended to strengthen and seal the area around Tyler. The metallic tiles that had caused oxidation during Flight 10 were also removed. Additionally, several tiles were intentionally removed at specific points to test the system's robustness and gather further information on heat dissipation and material durability. The success of these upgrades was immediately apparent during the mission, as the heat shield again became a focal point, particularly during re-entry. From the instant the payload was released, the altitude of Starship began to slowly decline as it readied itself for the rigorous journey through Earth's atmosphere. By the time the mission reached the 39-minute mark post-launch, the re-entry phase commenced earnestly and a sphere of plasma formed due to the extreme heat generated when Starship encountered the thickening atmospheric layers became apparent. This occurrence became even more striking in the subsequent minutes, reaching its peak around 1 hour into the mission, when the spacecraft moved through the densest section of the atmosphere. Eventually, the brilliant light started to diminish and ultimately vanished as Starship reduced its speed during descent. During this time frame, the heat shield faced intense temperatures and aerodynamic forces, yet it functioned impeccably. Two primary obstacles needed addressing: safeguarding the aft flaps and tackling the coolant oxidation issue that had impacted Flight 10. Impressively, both objectives were successfully met. The aft flaps, in particular, received significant attention. These essential control surfaces are crucial for maintaining stability and directing Starship during its descent, particularly at elevated speeds. Due to their location, the aft flaps endure considerably greater heat and aerodynamic strain compared to the forward flaps, making their protection particularly challenging. Engineers at SpaceX reinforced these sections with enhanced tile coverage and structural shielding, ensuring the flaps remained intact and operational throughout the re-entry phase. The outcomes were exceptional. After over 20 minutes in harsh atmospheric conditions, the aft flaps were in remarkable condition. The enhancements evidently produced positive results. One of the most noticeable upgrades took place on the leeward side of the flaps, where SpaceX installed additional heat shield tiles. These tiles aided in absorbing and redistributing the intense thermal energy, thus protecting the underlying stainless steel framework from overheating. However, perhaps the most critical aspect was the defense of the joint area that links the flaps to the primary structure of Starship. This junction is considered one of the most susceptible sections of the spacecraft, as it needs to endure both mechanical strain and extreme temperatures. During re-entry, detailed monitoring of the camera feeds revealed visible sparks and color changes in the tiles surrounding the joints. Yet the system remained intact. The heat shield effectively handled the stresses without observable damage or deformation. This performance positioned Starship from Flight 11 at a level comparable to or even exceeding the capabilities exhibited by S-26 during Flight 6, which was previously seen as the most successful Starship landing test before this mission. It is also notable that this flight incorporated an extra experimental test. At the 58-minute mark, SpaceX performed a bank maneuver aimed at mimicking the future Starship re-entry flight path for a powered landing at Starbase. This operation evaluated the spacecraft's ability to manage its descent angle and orientation, preparing for a future capture system utilizing the launch tower arms. For this assessment to be effective, the heat shield must maintain stability during re-entry, and it did so successfully. In conclusion, the results of Flight 11 demonstrate that Starship's heat shield has reached an exceptional level of development. The effectiveness of the re-entry and the spacecraft's excellent condition afterward demonstrate that SpaceX is moving toward its ultimate goal of full reusability. This mission also underscored how incremental improvements and data-driven refinements continue to shape SpaceX's development approach. Each test flight brings Starship closer to the operational stage, not only for Earth-to-orbit missions, but also for future trips to the Moon and Mars. Insights gained from Flight 11's heat shield will directly impact future designs and materials, ensuring Starship can handle multiple re-entries with minimal repairs. Therefore, after witnessing these remarkable results, it's safe to conclude that Flight 11 represents a significant milestone for SpaceX. The heat shield functioned flawlessly. Recent improvements demonstrated its effectiveness, bringing us closer to the vision of a fully reusable interplanetary spacecraft. Do you think this flight was a successful and crucial moment for the Starship heat shield? Share your thoughts in the comments with yes or no. Either way, with this achievement, SpaceX is ready to look to the future with renewed optimism. The proven resilience of Starship's heat shield during re-entry marks a critical point, opening new avenues for progress. Now ready to face the intense descent through Earth's atmosphere, Starship is closer to achieving true reusability. However, as with all aspects of the Starship initiative, change remains constant. Following the latest flight, SpaceX revealed that the upcoming 12th flight will introduce the new Starship D3 iteration. According to SpaceX, this version will be a complete redesign, incorporating a series of significant and advanced improvements. One of the most vital systems to be upgraded is the heat shield itself. This upcoming version will likely involve changes in materials, configuration, and installation techniques, as well as possible new design features like the crunch wrap pattern that has been a topic of discussion among engineers. Recently, SpaceX introduced a segment called S39, which appears to already feature next-generation heat shield tiles. However, the full extent of the modifications will only be understood once the rest of the spacecraft is completed. This latest version could provide important information about how SpaceX intends to improve the efficiency, durability, and maintainability of the heat shield across multiple flights. Regarding the flight schedule, it seems unlikely that SpaceX will attempt a full recovery and return of the spacecraft on Flight 12, which is the initial V3 checkpoint. Instead, the company is expected to attempt this goal between Flights 13 and 15. If SpaceX successfully returns Starship and conducts a full post-flight assessment with positive results, it would be one of the most significant achievements in Starship's entire development process. Effectively reusing the heat shield would mark progress even NASA's Space Shuttle program struggled to achieve. However, overcoming these obstacles will be challenging. Future flights will involve longer and more demanding tasks, such as reaching full orbital velocity and completing a full orbit around the planet. This will expose Starship to more demanding re-entry conditions for longer durations. This will be a true assessment of the durability of the new heat shield and the spacecraft's overall design. Beyond re-entry, the progress demonstrated on Flight 11 also supports SpaceX's goal of interplanetary travel. One of the company's boldest aspirations is to send Starship to Mars. However, Mars presents a new set of challenges for the heat shield due to its much thinner atmosphere compared to Earth's. This means that safely decelerating a spacecraft requires a careful balance between heat management and aerodynamic control. The success of Flight 11 could motivate SpaceX to begin developing specialized heat shields for various environments. There are already signs that the company is investigating materials capable of withstanding extremely high temperatures, possibly simulating the conditions experienced during re-entry to Mars. This evaluation could lead to a new version of Starship's heat shield specifically designed for optimal performance in the low-density atmosphere. Official information on such progress could emerge as early as next year, when SpaceX plans to resume uncrewed missions to Mars. Depending on developments, these missions could occur as early as the end of next year or within the next 3.5 years. Beyond interplanetary projects, the effectiveness of Starship's heat shield will also significantly impact SpaceX's near-term goals related to Earth orbit. With a more reliable and reusable structure, SpaceX can perform more complex tasks, such as in-orbit refueling, as well as handle larger payloads, and even crewed missions in the future. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next time.